Good morning. My name is Rick Tancredi, and I'm here at the RV Corral in Eugene, Oregon on a beautiful summer day. Appreciate you tuning in. I'm here to show you a 2002 Winnebago Brave that's recently come to us, a nice used motorhome, 30 feet. So for those of you that are looking for something a little smaller, this might interest you. And before I start, please feel free to call me if I miss something. I'm going to go around these pretty quickly so I don't bore you to death, but it'll give you a little bit of better feel for what you're looking at than the still pictures do. Just call and ask for Rick. My contact information is on the site, and I'll get any information you might need. Again, 2002. This is a 30W floor plan. Been a mainstay in the Winnebago line for a lot of years. Single slide, 30 footer. This is on a workhorse chassis. It's got 50,800 miles. It is in nice condition, aside from a few little minor flaws, but again, it's a 2002, so this is a motorhome that's over 10 years old, but it'll be very serviceable for many, many years to come. For those of you that aren't looking to spend the big bucks. Power mirrors, of course. A couple of things about Winnebago. If you're just tuning in, maybe you're looking for a 30-foot Class A. Why should I buy a Winnebago Brave? Winnebago has a long-standing tradition of building fine motorhomes. Over 50 years, they have one of the strongest frameworks in the industry. One of the few true roll cage steel frames, and that's included up into the cockpit area also. This firewall, very heavy steel. Most manufacturers just use wood, and this would be the most vulnerable area in case of a collision. Winnebago does do crash testing, the only manufacturer I know of in the industry that does. So they're very concerned that everything holds together and that you're safe in this. So there's the reason to buy a Winnebago. Fiberglass one-piece roof, another nice feature. Also, the availability of parts and service for Winnebago. Been around a long, long time. All their parts made in-house or virtually all. So you've got a good supply, and you will have. So another good reason to consider Winnebago. The RV Corral's been a Winnebago dealer for 16 years, and we have excellent service department also. So let's just go around this side here. I'm looking at the outside fiberglass, trying to give you a little, the fiberglass has just a little bit of fade to it, I suppose. It's still in very good shape. I don't see any delamination. Our graphics here are rolling just a little bit on some of these edges. Now, these can be replaced. Graphics are kind of spendy to replace. And in most cases, I think the owner of this would live with it the way it is. Certainly acceptable. I think this is considered normal wear and tear. Motorhomes nowadays are painted, so they hold up more like your car. But, not bad. Just don't want you to think that it's perfect, because there's just, like I said, these edges and some of these areas right down here just rolling a bit. But still nice color. If you step back 10 feet, you don't really even notice it. Nice stainless steel wheel covers here. Tires look to be in good condition and may have been, replaced. Many of these are dated. I'm not sure I see that. But these are not the original. These are Toyos, probably been replaced fairly recently. Slide topper on top of the slide room to protect the roof. Nice deep tinted windows, as is typical with Winnebago. The cargo bays on this slide out with the bays. Oh, looks like we got some equipment from the previous owners. How nice. I'd have to take that one. I'm kidding. Anyway, everything looks pretty clean here. 30 amp shore power, service bay, nice and clean in a washable compartment. Dumps easy to get to, outside shower. 5,500 watt Onan Marquee, which would have been an option on this coach. Most of these would have 4,000 water. So that's an upgraded generator, good size, plenty of power. coming around this side. We do have a backup camera, trailer hitch, ladder. Again, a fiberglass roof up there is the best roof in the industry. And really, aside from these graphics, just letting go a little bit, some spots here on the Winnebago, I see them rolling just a little bit. Nice motorhome. Toyo tires, got a nice big patio awning, power step. Outside entertainment center, this has got AM, FM, stereo, TV connections for entertainment outside. Let's go inside here quickly and see what I can show you here. The floor plan is a big story on this 30W. Again, for a short motorhome, quite roomy. The slide is the kitchen and the booth dinette. For those of you that like a booth dinette, it's a large one, makes a large bed, and then sofa opposite. And this will be a jackknife style sofa, but does make a bed. Both of these chairs, of course, will swivel to become part of your living area. But nice and clean up here. This will have the 8100 Vortec Chevy motor in it. Allison transmission on the workhorse chassis. This does have levelers, the camera, old style TV naturally for an O2 motorhome up here, and but it's good size, and we've got some electronics, looks like a little inverter here, and DVD player over here. So, you know, they've upgraded a bit. Had a nice dash cover, so I would assume the dash is all in nice condition. This has been covered. A slide out deck here for your laptops, possibly. The upholstery in here is a blue kind of floral. Carpet is a light blue. Window coverings are day and night pleated shades, and they look to be in good condition. Padded valances, dual pane windows, of course. Nice condition, little L-shape, well, more of a U-shaped kitchen here, so you get a little counter space on this side. Gas oven, microwave. Cabinet space and a 30-footer are often a problem, but looks like this is pretty adequate here. 60-40 sink. 8-cubic-foot refrigerator. Clean. Clean, smells good, that's important. Got a nice clean headliner, fantastic fan, fluorescent lighting. This unit has double roof airs, which would have been optional also on a 30-footer. Probably could have got by with one. That's why it has the larger generator, so it'll run both roof airs. So plenty of air in here for those of you that want to go south if it happens to get a little warm. Then we head into the bathroom area here. This has the Neo angle shower here, and then your sink and toilet on the other side, in a little bit of a jog here to give you a little privacy to the bedroom. Nice idea. It's a good floor plan. They're not making it anymore. You know, nowadays a 30-footer might have three slide outs in it, but it's also going to be three times as much money. A lot of nice cabinetry in here, overheads, vanity, three drawers, foot flush toilet. Very clean. Don't see any excess wear, no gouges, nicks. We've got pretty large wardrobe here, shirt closet on the other side. It's a queen bed, forward facing. Plenty of room, more wardrobe on this side. This is hanging space, drawers. All in all, an excellent motorhome. I'm sure I've missed some things. If you have an interest in this, give me a call and I can fill in the blanks and help you to own this if you like. We'll take your trade in, arrange financing, whatever you need. And the RV Corral's been here 26 years making campers happy, so let me know how I can help you. Again, my name is Rick. I'm in the sales department at the RV Corral. Give me a call. Let me know how I can help. Thank you.